Welcome to NTN Nightly. I am Janelle Nouvelle. This edition's top stories. A robust plan by government for capital projects has positioned Saint Lucia for 3% economic growth. The impact of natural disasters on the National Social Protection System is examined. On this World Water Day, government ensures that no one is left behind. All that plus the latest in youth development, sports, and the NTN Nouvelle, Kweyol. A robust plan by the government of Saint Lucia for the execution of capital projects has positioned the island for 3% growth in the economy this year. The Caribbean Development Bank, CDB, in making the projection, attributed the upswing to public sector construction programs coming on stream. The institution, however, noted that implementation of the projects is key. Prime Minister the Honorable Alan Chasney has agreed, indicating that the government decided to introduce a delivery unit for this very reason.
In the Tourism Economic Review 2018 Saint Lucia, the CDB said that tourism activities are projected to expand and agriculture output will remain buoyant. Prime Minister the Honorable Alan Chasney highlighted some of the projects soon to come on stream.
In terms of the major capital projects, obviously the airport, we've been in negotiations the whole of this year. We're very happy that those negotiations have been completed. We've gotten approval from the Exim Bank of Taiwan. My understanding is that the contract for the roads has now been signed with the contractor, and we're very close to finalizing the contract with the airport. Although parts of the airport have already been approved and are proceeding, the main body of the airport will be commencing very, very shortly, and will have completed those contract negotiations.
The government of Saint Lucia recently undertook a project geared at enhancing the capacity of public and private sector workers to facilitate the strategic implementation of projects. A number of training workshops have been held in that regard, and a delivery unit is soon to be established within the office of the Prime Minister. Prime Minister Chasney indicated that many of the projects are expected to commence in 2019.
Next year is going to be a very big year for Saint Lucia. You know, with the airport, which is $175 million, the roads, which are about $114 million EC in the first instance, with another $60 to $70 million EC dollars to be followed up over the next 2 years. We're very close to finalizing the home port facility in Vieuxfort. We have completed the loan agreement for St. Jude's, which is $30 million US. $10 million US is the carryover from the Taiwanese load, and we've now added another $20 million US dollars to it. And we're also in the final stages of finalizing the $30 million US dollar loan for the police headquarters. And the police headquarters will include 6 courts in the design. My understanding is that they've met with the National Trust, and that we've obtained, I believe, approval from them in terms of what we're doing and how we're handling in the design. So we're all very encouraged that that's going to be taking place very quickly.
The Prime Minister highlighted some of the tourism projects to come on stream, including the 800-room Hyatt to be constructed at Chalk, the Marriott Courtyard at Point Seraphine, and the 300-room Honeymoon Beach project, to name a few.
Saint Lucia, as chair of the Caribbean Forum of African, Caribbean, and the Pacific States, CARIFORUM, has played a key role in formalizing an agreement between the grouping and the United Kingdom in the face of Brexit. Anicia Antoine has the details.
The CARIFORUM member states and the United Kingdom have officially signed the CARIFORUM United Kingdom Economic Partnership Agreement. The agreement has been in the making since 2017 and seeks to remove taxes on exports from the CARIFORUM member states to the United Kingdom to make the products more competitive. Chair of the CARIFORUM and Minister for Commerce, International Trade and Investment, Enterprise Development and Consumer Affairs of Saint Lucia, Honorable Bradley Felix, explained that the CARIFORUM recognizes the importance of securing the existing trade agreements and avoiding disruption of the preferential trade agreement.
The UK is our largest trading partner in the European Union, as it currently absorbs approximately 25% of the region's total exports to Europe. Bananas, rum, sugar, rice, agro-processed goods, and methanol are among our major exports to the UK. With regard to service and investment, the UK has provided significant guarantees of access to its market offering and many other opportunities for our exporters. We are committed to working closely with the United Kingdom to ensure that our service providers can take further advantage of this market.
The United Kingdom is scheduled to exit the European Union on March 29, 2019. Honorable George Hollenberry is the Minister of State for Trade Policy in the Department of International Trade of the United Kingdom.
Of course, today's signing is a very, very important moment for all of our nations, recognising as it does the importance of allowing trade between CARIFORUM and the UK to continue uninterrupted post-Brexit, whatever those circumstances may be. Our nations have traded for a long time. They trade with each other profitably. Our consumers rely on many of the products that our relationship allows to cross borders. And I am incredibly pleased to be here today to allow the signing of an agreement that allows that to continue as it always had.
Saint Lucia was amongst the 9 member states of the CARIFORUM, which together with the United Kingdom, signed the agreement on Friday, March 22, 2019. From the Government Information Service, I am Anicia Antoine reporting.
The impact natural disasters can have on the island's national social protection system came in for thorough discussion this week at the Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment. More from Chevroy Marius.
Climate shocks are not only responsible for increasing humanitarian crisis, but are also leading factors in augmenting poverty and food insecurity in St. Lucia. To deal with this situation, countries must implement systems that can respond effectively to protect the vulnerable who depend directly on social services for their survival and welfare. To accomplish this task, on Tuesday, March 19th, the Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment, in partnership with the United Nations World Food and the Caribbean Disaster Emergency Management Agency, CDEMA, held a consultation at the Ministry's conference room. United Nations World Food Representative Ms. Francesca Cadilla stated that the procedure will commence with the examination of the social services of the social protection system.
Our focus in St. Lucia is to really look at how national social protection system can coexist as part of disaster risk management protocols and procedures in the event of an emergency. We are delighted to be here, to be invited to be part of the, to carry out the study. We're looking at analyzing these systems from 5 technical areas: coordination, financing, information management, data management and targeting mechanisms.
Disaster caused by weather-related hazards impose large costs on the country's fragile economy and exacerbates poverty levels. They have destroyed infrastructure and disrupted the provision of essential services.
We do envisage that whatever findings come out of this, we'll use it to strengthen the overall social protection system in St. Lucia, and hopefully that we have a more responsive social protection system that responds to natural disasters.
Social protection can help people manage climate and disaster risk by helping the most vulnerable to respond before the disaster happens. Reporting from the Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Local Government and Empowerment, I am Chevroy Marius.
The Department of Agriculture, Fisheries, Physical Planning, Natural Resources and Cooperatives, in partnership with the Water Resources Management Agency, has begun a week of activities placing the spotlight on the island's water resources in observation of March 22 as World Water Day. Here's Amanda Faye Clark.
Designated some 26 years ago by the United Nations General Assembly, World Water Day has become a hallmark which emphasizes and evaluates the progress made by governments and societies around the world in commissioning systems to ensure that every citizen, particularly children, have access to clean and safe water. In St. Lucia this year, the priority is placed on assisting vulnerable communities prepare for drought-like conditions and extreme flooding during the hurricane season. And as such, the Water Resource Management Agency have embarked on an education drive to sensitize students on newly erected water level systems around the island. Water Resource Officer Mervyn Ejiz says this approach taken for St. Lucia's observance of World Water Day is timely, as it takes place at a time of year when our environment is most prone to prolonged dry spells, while at the same time, communities revised their disaster response mechanisms and put in motion a plan for the hurricane season. The first education and outreach activities for students took place at the Bexo Primary School and the Babino Secondary School this week.
We plan to visit as many schools as possible, and actually tomorrow we'll be going to Babino Secondary School. And on Friday, we have a fair actually going to be held in Sufre, at the waterfront in Sufre. So at all schools will be invited and so on. And Wednesday and Thursday, we're going to have a school fair as well in a college where schools will be coming to visit, and we'll be demonstrating our various equipment and what do we do at the Water Management Agency and the importance of water and water conservation for the general public and for the future of St. Lucia.
The installation of water level systems in vulnerable communities like Bexar gives NEMO and community disaster responders a greater level of control in managing flood responses.
First of all, when the level of the water rises, it can send a very simple SMS. Right now it's functioning with SMS, text messages, and you can send text messages to three persons at the same time. Actually, right now I think it's Water Management Agency, the director, someone from the community, meaning from the disaster community, will be added to the contact list, and someone from NEMO, the National Emergency Management Organization. So all three key personnel could get information that when the level rises, they could respond to it.
This year's theme for World Water Day is Leaving No One Behind, a message the Water Resources Management Agency hope will raise awareness that indeed water is a human right, but also greater management and intervention in securing water resources is equally important in ensuring St. Lucia's socio-economic development. From the Ministry of Agriculture, I am Amanda Faye Clark reporting.
This is NTN Nightly, coming up the latest happenings in youth development and sports with Ryan O'Brien.
Pamela, I noticed that you built your retaining wall on my property. You will have to give me my land back or compensate me for that.
My contractor isn't dumb. I trust that he will not build anything on your property. Where is your proof?
Let's go to court.
This situation does not require you to go to court. Looks like we have to go through mediation here. Mediation is a way people resolve conflicts like this. Someone, a third party, comes to speak to both parties. This person is called the mediator. The mediator is impartial. He or she makes sure that communication between both parties is effective and efficient.
So, the mediator is a judge?
No, the mediator is not a judge. Mediators, unlike judges, do not decide cases or impose settlements.
Let me get a mediator to handle this retaining wall and that kitchen.
Kitchen?
Yes, your kitchen also falls on my land. Let me call the mediator.
Welcome back. We join Ryan O'Brien for the latest happenings in youth development and sports.
Hello once again. I'm Ryan O'Brien with your update from the Ministry of Youth Development and Sports on the NTN Nightly News. Following last week's launch of the Youth Mentorship Program under the initiative of the Ministry of Youth Development and Sports, several stakeholders will also be the focus of attention during the conduct of the program. One such group is that of parenting. Parental engagement will take the format of a 12-week parenting group in which parents will be led through a psycho-educational curriculum by a trained counselor. Topics will include emotional intelligence, anger management, positive parenting practices, and youth development issues. The group will also play the role of a support group where parents will have the opportunity to share their experiences. The program's effectiveness will be evaluated on an ongoing basis, engaging both process and outcome evaluation modalities. The Ministry of Youth Development and Sports has recorded a successful week of preliminaries in track and field as schools from the south and north of the island sent participants to qualifiers from which the cream of the crop will emerge to participate in the inter-secondary schools track and field championships, down to be held at the Darren Sammy Cricket Ground Wednesday and Friday next week. The Northern Zone qualifiers ended Friday afternoon. The format of the championship allows for semi-finals and finals to be held on both days. So there will also be keen interest on both days. In other words, semi-finals and finals on Wednesday and semi-finals and finals on Friday as well. So the place to be next week, if you are a track and field fan and keen on witnessing some of the talent that's possibly going to represent St. Lucia at Curvetta Games this year, then you have to be at the Darren Sammy Cricket Ground next Wednesday and Friday for Intersect. And before we leave you for the weekend, another snippet as we keep the focus on Youth Month. Today we look at Youth Service Week, April 15th to the 20th. The concept is for youth groups, organizations, and individuals to be encouraged to show acts of kindness and volunteerism through service projects. Images must be captured and posted to Youth and Sports St. Lucia Facebook page. Photos can also be posted using the hashtag YSW2019. Most liked act of kindness will be recognized at Youth Awards at the end of April. And that's your update for the Ministry of Youth Development and Sports this week. I'm Ryan O'Brien, saying goodbye until next time.
Thanks, Ryan. The Dental Services Unit of the Department of Health and Wellness continues on its mandate to promote good oral health of St. Lucians through effective education and promotion activities. More from Fernell Neptune.
As part of observing World Oral Health Day on March 20th, the various dental clinics around the island hosted an open day for patients, providing information on effective oral health. Senior dental surgeon in the Department of Health and Wellness, Dr. Sherry Ephraim Nocomte, says it is important that St. Lucians are aware of the issues surrounding oral health and work towards oral hygiene.
The theme for World Oral Health Day this year is Say Ah! Act on mouth health. Basically, it means that if we put into practice these hygiene habits, including a visit to the dentist every 6 months, as well as manage the risk factors, we can have better outcomes for our overall general health. According to the Nutrition Unit of the Department of Health and Wellness, reducing our sugar intake to no more than 3 teaspoons a day for a child or 9 teaspoons for an adult is best advised. In addition, the Substance Abuse Unit also advises to avoid smoking and consuming alcohol, just as the World Dental Federation has proposed.
Dental hygienist Cheryl Sincere says this year, the Dental Services Unit has launched its halitosis campaign as a means of raising awareness of oral health.
We want to highlight or to bring an awareness of the condition halitosis. Halitosis actually warns us and it also tells us that there is gum disease maybe going on with you, or you may have decay, or simply that you need to visit the dentist. Visiting the dentist will tell you about other conditions that may have caused your halitosis. And as we know that many people, they would not want to tell another person, hey, you have halitosis. And halitosis is just really bad breath and can easily be resolved by your home treatment of brushing and flossing regularly and visiting your dentist at least twice a year, or once a year is all right as well.
As part of the halitosis campaign, the Dental Services Unit will introduce a dental comic strip competition aimed at starting island-wide conversation on oral health, non-communicable diseases, NDCs, and overall health. Reporting from the Communications Unit of the Ministry of Health and Wellness, I am Fernell Neptune.
Stay with NTN Nightly. Up next, Primus Hutchinson is here with the NTN Nouvelle, a Kweyol.
You think you're invincible?
You think it can only happen to certain people?
Yeah! Yeah, man! Be smart! Think.
Glove up when you love up.
Welcome back. We join Primus Hutchinson for the NTN Nouvelle, a Kweyol.
Merci autant, Janelle. Monsieur et Madame, Département qui est responsabilité pour information en gouvernement cette fois-ci, ça c'est GIS, la CVP Télévision Nationale, PIA NTN, car vous êtes au Nouvelle, à Kweyol, vous êtes au Primus Hutchinson. Il y a un agrément entre ces pays qui m'ont carré forum, la CVP, pays l'Angleterre, à d'ailleurs, gymnase économique. Si un argument qui a porté avec qui protéger ces pays là n'importe les l'Angleterre sorti quand même l'Union européenne. Ministre la Kenya responsabilité pour affaires industrie commerce développement investissement on est Bradley Félix de parmi plusieurs ministres gouvernement Hod Kawibla qui était signé agrément ça là et puis les représentatifs l'Angleterre. Selon on est Félix, agrément ça là c'est pour protéger ces pays là comme l'Angleterre en chemin pour sortir en loin l'Union Europe. Monsieur Félix fait nous comprendre qui agrément ça là c'est pour établir une assurance pour ces pays ça là pour pas souffrir et puis produire que yo ka vendre à l'Angleterre.
So ça nous fait aujourd'hui bien important de faire assurer bah nous qui allons à l'Angleterre pas qu'il ni taxe en l'air pour faire goods nous plus competitif avec mon l'Angleterre qui ça acheter. Mais si vous pas fait ça yo ka dit bah nous trop cher. So ça nous fait aujourd'hui bien bien important. So actuellement nous ni nous ka ni deux arrangements yon avec l'Angleterre et yon avec l'Union européenne. So mais tout ça ka c'est qui ça qui est arrivé et si l'Angleterre qui a quitté les lions dans nos affaires nous have arrangé.
Gwako Fonsala t'es fait un hôtel Harbor Club à Rodney Bay jeudi pour vendredi. Malgré un loge à fait par le gouvernement pour ménager le service de l'eau à cette ci l'année en pile qui ça fait toujours. Ça, c'est l'opinion du ministre qui est responsable pour l'agriculture honorable Ezekiel Joseph. Selon le ministre Joseph, le gouvernement en bas responsabilité du ministère de l'Agriculture et c'est l'autre agence qui m'a maillé et puis le ministère, j'ai implémenté un bas programme et facilité pour développer un service qui peut payer à car c'est vrai un résultat de bonne qualité de l'eau.
Se louve se pouje a ki nou a koumanse, ki pouje ki de, si pou koumanse 8-10 lani pase, for example, John Compton Dam, nou a koumanse ka really fè travèl la ki nesesè a pou asire set lise da si nou yon mouve drought, dat nou sa ne glou pli lontan pase sa nou ka eksperyans atuelman. Nou wè dat nou fè pouje a Denry North, an Mabia Valley a. Nous commençons à poser là, nous faire phase 1 et puis nous faire phase 2 pour faire un plus reliable supply of glue. Nous avons un babono, nous faisons chaque travail avec babono. Actuellement, si un babono, nous avons reçu un plus reliable supply of glue. Aussi, en Microsoft, l'année prochaine, notre honorable Assam Jim s'est commencé from longtemps, il y a un là, pour faire une manière à moi à ce que ça, il pouvait se faire glue dans Microsoft. Quand nous vivons le gouvernement, nous commencer projet ça et projet ça a fini. Le nouvel ancillary, le projet ancillary nous laisse ouvert pour bail Jean Aslaw et plus quality glow. C'est aussi important. Hein? C'est bail glow parce que quality glow est important aussi. Nous avons un bouton DLC. So nous avons fait un chai travail avec le gouvernement, avec la compagnie Levin pour glow.
Journée internationale pour de l'eau, quand vous avez observé vendredi, le 20 en mois de mars. Projet pour établir primaire protection à ce chemin cette ici, j'ai reçu un bon coup de chapeau. C'est pour ça la sortie Rod May pour Ville Castry, Peterson Francis. Mais Francis a félicité le projet qui est en place à présent. Il a fait assessment des meilleures protections à ce chemin PIA. Mais Francis a assisté à une cérémonie jeudi le 14 mars au ministère pour construction et travaux pour établir le programme ça. Projet ça là, c'est pour déterminer qui meilleure qualité action qui s'est faite pour délivrer meilleure protection pour les gens qui ont servi chemin à cette ici. Pour ça là, j'ai l'occasionné pour l'année plus signe de trafic et que ce signe qui a offert meilleure direction au niveau du pays là. L'année aussi, programme pour marcher ce chemin ça là et pour placer barrage de protection. Selon Mère Francis, il a cru que le programme international des assessments chemin n'est pas seulement pour tuer meilleure protection à ce chemin cette ci mais qui aussi sauver la vie et qui bail à porter bon bénéfice pour Ville Castry. Francis pleurait d'ici quantité la vie qui j'a perdu à des causes d'accident à ce chemin cette ci mais Francis déclare qu'il te plaît que gouvernement prenne l'initiative ça là qui a véritablement sauver la vie parce que selon Francis les citoyens pays qui est bien capable de produire, qui a perdu la vie à ce chemin, ça a posé un chai qui est lourd et qui a affecté le développement généralement. Et c'est comme ça que nous avons une bonne nouvelle, messieurs, mesdames. Je vous remercie autant pour vous garder. Je vous remercie une invitation pour jouer. Et puis, moi encore, c'est là que je vous remercie à l'autre nouvelle à Kweyol. Je vous souhaite une bonne fin de semaine et nous vous remercie pour le channel.
Here's a look at what's happening to us weather-wise.
The Atlantic high pressure system will maintain a moderate to brisk easterly wind flow across Saint Lucia and the rest of the Eastern Caribbean over the next few days. Low-level clouds drifting with this flow will bring some showers over the islands during the next 24 hours. The tide for Castries Harbour was high at 5:13 p.m. and will be low again at 10:43 p.m. The tides for Vieux-Fort Bay was low at 12:03 p.m. and will be high again at 6:20 p.m. Seas moderate with waves 4 to 6 feet or 1.2 to 1.8 meters. The sun will rise Saturday at 6:06 a.m.
That brings us to the end of NTN Nightly. Join us next time at 7 p.m. with a repeat at 7 a.m. You can also catch up with us anytime on the St. Lucia Government Facebook page or YouTube channel. I am Janelle Norville.